the National Registry of Historic Places since 1986, the Deering Estate at Cutler Ridge is a 444-acre environmental, archaeological, historical, and architectural preserve owned by the state of Florida and managed by Miami-Dade County Parks and Recreation. Today we'll be touring the Deering Estate, and I'm your host, Alex, from Culture Lifestyle Travel. And welcome to the Deering Estate. Hope you enjoy it. Charles Deering had first been attracted to Miami by his father, William, who had a winter home in Coconut Grove. In 1913, Charles purchased 60 acres of hardwood hammock south of Miami. With downtown Miami growing rapidly and railroad development spreading southward, Charles feared for the future of the native hammock and the pine lands. With an intent to preserve the land, Charles worked for 10 years to assemble parcels from spectator corporations and the remaining settlers of Cutler Ridge. He brought in renowned botanist Dr. David Fairchild to oversee the landscaping and conduct plant research on his properties. Charles Deering was distressed by the drainage of the Everglades and the devastation of the forest, predicting that it would change the climate, and in turn, he did his best to preserve as much as he could the area around what we know today as the Deering Estate. When the Richmond Cottage closed as a hotel, Charles bought the hotel in 1916. He then remodeled it as a winter home for his family in 1918. Here we're going to take a quick tour of the Richmond Cottage. This house was built in the 1900s, and Edith S.H. Richmond's wife opened the house as an inn called the Richmond Cottage. Guests who stayed in the Richmond Cottage, according to the 1900 register of the inn, include Henry Morris Flagler and James Ingram. Charles Deering bought the Richmond Cottage in 1916. Over the next several years, he added different structures to the estate, including a carriage house, pump house, a powerhouse, and he also enclosed the estate with a limestone and concrete wall and built a boat turning basin in Biscayne Bay. In 1922, he completed the three-story Mediterranean stone house and moved into Cutler Ridge in 1922. As you can see, this is a Gilded Age era house, and it has running water for the plumbing system thanks to the pump house. If these walls could talk, I wonder what they would say. There's so much history in these homes. In 1979, they found a sinkhole on the estates which contained fossilized animal bones that go back 2 million years. Here's some examples of the fossilized bones. Not only did they find bones on the property, but they also found relics from the Tequesta Indian, which were native to this area. Alright, we're going to make our way to the main house, which is also known as the stone house. Deering wanted to build a place to house hundreds of pieces of art and books he cherished, he collected throughout the years. In 1922, he decided to build a new structure alongside his Richmond cottage. He designed the three-story Mediterranean-style house, remembering the disastrous Chicago fire. Charles wanted to make sure the building was fireproof, and the building was made up of limestone and poured concrete walls, with copper-clad brass doors and no kitchen. The stone house became a treasure trove of masterpieces. The ballroom was lined floor to ceiling with artwork, including a stately fireplace given to Charles by his brother James. And here you can see the fireplace. Moving on to the other parts of the house, we'll go to Charles Deering's bedroom. As you can see in this bedroom, everything has been reimagined to bring back to life the Gilded Era age. One thing that doesn't disappoint is the views out of each and every one of these windows. We are now entering what is known as Charles Deering's home office area. With an office like this and a view like that, only brilliant ideas can come about. Let's take a peek and see what we can see. Here in the showcase, you can see hairpins, makeup containers, and perfume bottles that were from Marion's collection, Charles Deering's wife. Just look at these exquisite details that these perfume bottles have. And here's a pair of 17th century armchairs that were carved by hand. Here you can pause and take a minute to read a little bit about the history of these armchairs. Welcome to the library. This space is a combination of books original to Charles Deering's personal collection. In the 1920s, Charles Deering's personal library was said to be the second largest personal library in the country. Charles had a collection of works ranging from the classics like Lewis Carroll's Alice in Wonderland to Shakespeare and many others. The full range of reading material here highlights Charles' thirst for knowledge and his interest in all things art, history, and culture. Back in the Prohibition era, if you were a wealthy person, you had your own speakeasy. The This wine cellar was concealed behind a movable shelf wall and a 3-ton bank vault door. For over 30 years, this space was virtually forgotten. The doors had jammed shut in 1945 after a devastating hurricane, and details about this space were virtually non-existent. It literally disappeared. I mean, back in the Prohibition era, that's what you wanted, am I right? Back in 1992, the safe was cracked open, and there was about 8,000 bottles of wine and spirits untouched. Can you imagine? Thanks to the dedicated conservation efforts, we're now able to enjoy this room. Today, you can see that the space is reimagined to its original form, even with the same bottles that were left behind by Charles Deering. As you can see, there are many different types of wine bottles, spirits, from all sorts of different places. Personally, this room is my favorite room, and not only because it's a room full of spirits, but because of the backstory it has. This is a true gem of the Deering Estate. I'm sure that if Charles Deering were to see what his estate has become, he would be very proud. We hope you enjoyed this video that we did for the Deering Estate, and we do recommend you coming and visiting. The Deering Estate is a true gem here in South Florida. It's one of those little hidden places. If you enjoyed our video, please give it a like, share with your friends, subscribe if you haven't, and please join us in our next video. In our next video, we'll be visiting Vizcaya for a special event. The Vizcaya Light Parade. Vizcaya is the home of James Deering, the brother of Charles Deering. This event takes place at night, and we'll take you around and check out the sights. If you would like to support our channel, you can check out the description below where you can get apparel, stickers, and mugs. By supporting our channel, it keeps these videos going.